In order to open my Colab Notebook, go to the link under this video and open Google Colab Notebook for running Stable Diffusion. And yes, I am absolutely right. We can use Stable Diffusion in Google Colab once again, like in a good old days. And as usual, absolutely free, without any warnings and any problems. In this case, with Invoke, which is actually super cool and super slick user interface, but for some reason not so popular. Outpaging, inpaging, ControlNet, LoRa, everything already there. But we will discuss it a bit later. For now, let's get back to the notebook. First of all, in order to avoid any errors and problems, don't hurry and listen, please, carefully. It will save you a lot of time, just trust me. First thing we need to do is change runtime. It's very important. It should be T4GPU. Then, as usual, run step 1. You don't need any additional Google Drive storage, because uploaded models are not stored on your Google Drive. After this session ends, all data will be deleted, including your generated arts. After finishing step 1, there will be disconnections, and don't worry, it's absolutely okay. We just need to run the next step, step 2. Here we go, our session just crashed and restarted. Everything is going according to the plan, don't be worried. Now we should download models. It's a bit tricky, not so easy as it was in my previous notebooks. In this case, we can configure this file, initialmodels.iaml, I suppose. You can click to this file and here all specified information about downloading your models. In this case, I'm downloading only Realistic Vision V5 as usual, and I should choose here in a recommended parameter true. There is a lot of other models, and you need to specify parameter for the models which you want to download. We download in this case several ControlNet models and LoRa models just for tests. You can do it by yourself without much troubles. But we download SD1.5 for some reason. Enter true, and without saving, without making anything, just close this file. And now just press run this cell, and we need wait a little bit. Very important information. You can download any models in InvokeAI, which is exceptionally convenient. So it's not so necessary downloading the model through this method. I also have ultimate version of that Colab notebook, which work locally, not locally, but in your Google Drive account. In this case, you don't have to download all models every time, tune your Invoke every time, specify the parameters, downloading upscalers and other things. All will be saved constantly, and you need just run one cell. But we will discuss it a bit later. For now, let's get back to the notebook.
Captain Felizzi.
In the beginning of the process, very important to change your runtime with the GPU manually, because if you change these parameters automatically, most likely that after starting the process, the session, you will get only CPU without GPU. In this case, you should restart your session, change runtime manually in T4 and run step 1, 2 and step 3 consequently. After 5 minutes waiting, we downloaded all needed models. And by the way, we've just also downloaded upscalers, which you can use in an InvokeAI immediately, which is really nice. Now the final step, step 3, run Stable Diffusion by pressing this button here. We just got our link, and don't hurry up, we need to wait a little bit. We are waiting for port connection, it just takes about 1 minute. Here we go, the port just connected and we can follow the link. We are in an InvokeAI. Let's test traditionally by generating another nice looking cat. There are, as you can see, several models which we choose in that config file. Let's choose Realistic Vision V5 once again and press Invoke. Yes. We did it. My congratulations. The best way to support my channel is to click the like button and watch this video until the end. You can rewind it at the beginning, mute the sound and let it play in the background. This will be greatly help with promotion and is the best way to show you appreciation of my work. If you encounter any issues, just write it below in the comments section and I will help you. For now, let's back to Invoke. Very important information. Here in Invoke, the standard parameter for steps is 50, so we can choose a little bit 20. There are already familiar to you parameters like image counts, steps, CFG scale, choose models, upscaler, which for some reason is scheduled. There are all popular upscalers. Here you can activate VAE, specify the precision of your VAE. Also parameters for seed, aspect ratio, which very nice, especially if you're working with SDXL, and of course InvokeAI support SDXL with the finer. And there are also ControlNet adapter, LoRa models. Actually, all needed information already here. There are also image to image tab, which works also really nice with the same parameters which you can see in automatic 1111, and fill canvas, really nice feature, and we can discuss this feature in our next video. Let me know if you want me to explain how to work with InvokeAI with a canvas, because it's really nice instrument with quite unique features. It works much more convenient than automatic 1111, and you can actually substitute your Photoshop AI with generative features by Invoke, because here it's even more convenient than Photoshop. There is also a workflow editor and, very important moment, model manager. Here you can download any models you like. Just press here, input models, and you should just paste model here in a model location. For example, let's download something from CVTI. Press right button here and click copy link address. And then we should just paste it here and press add model. Now we are downloading a model and model just added. Very nice. And here in a LoRa section we can choose our just downloaded model. We don't need to change location for our models, because Invoke automatically understood that is LoRa models and just located to their proper folder, which is exceptionally cool. You can also easily delete any models. Just paste the button here, and you can also merge models. Looks the same like it works in automatic 1111. And yes, there are also upscaler. Works very nice. You can just choose your upscaler. For example, let it be real ESC GAN plus, and press one button here. Very easy and exceptionally convenient. And we just got our upscaled images by pressing one button here. But it's not so convenient to download all models every time. In this case, I have ultimate version of my Colab notebook, which is available on my Patreon page. In this notebook, you can download all your models in a Google Drive account, or just used already downloaded models from your Google Drive and use it without any limitation with a fast boot, because in this case you don't have to download all that models and tune all parameters in your InvokeAI every time. Just run requirements and run Stable Diffusion. So let me show you how to do that. So this is my Stable Diffusion InvokeAI Ultimate Google Drive version, the best naming ever, I know that. And we need just run step one, connect our Google Drive account. I already did that. I already installed all needed models for me. So connect Google Drive. Here we go. We just installed our requirements, and we don't need to download models once again, because all models already in my Google Drive account, and we need just run Stable Diffusion in a step three. But there is some difference. The connection or your InvokeAI might be insecure. Not might be, it actually will be insecure, but it's absolutely okay. If your browser for some reason give you a warning that it is not safe for your browser, for your files, it's absolutely okay. Don't be scared, just press OK and open this site. Requirements has been installed, session has been crashed, everything is going according to the plan. We are missing step 2, I already downloaded the model, and just run step 3. Port just connected and follow the link. As I said before, this connection is not secure, but it's okay. Now, please note that InvokeAI even saved my previous prompt from my previous tests, which I do like it. And here we can see all my previous images which I generated. It's already stored here in a Google Drive, and also there are my models, only one model, realistic vision for tests, and LoRa models which I also downloaded, in this case Argentina doll likeness. To be honest, it's just random LoRa models which I downloaded from CVTI. So yeah, thanks for that. You can store all your models in Google Drive, or just used already existing models using my ultimate version of my notebook available on my Patreon page. But there are a lot of alternatives, like automatic 1111 with Kaggle notebooks, and it works also for free, and SageMaker Studio Lab also available here. I regularly update my notebooks, so you are welcome. Let me know if you want me to make detailed guide about InvokeAI, because to my mind is one of the best UI at this moment, but as I said before, for some reason not so popular. If you like this video, press like button and see you.